everybody. Welcome to another episode of Dark Millennium. I'm here with Jared. We haven't seen each other in forever. Jared used to go to pretty much every store in Toronto I ever managed. So you went to the Eaton Centre store, and then you went to the Young & Lawrence store. And now you're living in Muskoka, permanently taking care of a camp. You live the dream of my life.
I'm living the dream.
You're living the dream. He gets to go canoeing and hiking and just live in Muskoka. If you guys know what Muskoka is in Ontario, it's where rich people from Toronto own $1 trillion cabins and basically ride jet skis. And then the poor kids go and camp and ride around in canoes. And the movie Meatballs basically happens every summer. So, coolest place to live ever. He's come down with his Harlequin army to play him against my Imperial Guard. Now, I haven't played my Imperial Guard in a very long time. I think the last time I played them was in the 2012 Throne of Skulls tournament in Memphis. So if I suck and or get things wrong, I have not played them with the Astra Militarum Codex. But we're going to play a 1500 point Maelstrom of War game. Let's roll a mission, take a look at the armies, and we'll get started.
Here is 1500 points of Segarach's Revenge, which is the Laughing God. So what's in this formation?
All right, so I got three troops of Harlequins, one is six, two is seven, all of troop masters.
And one's the Warlord?
This guy here with the yellow mohawk is my Warlord.
Cool.
They're armed with a variety of weapons, Harlequin kisses, caresses, embraces, all that good stuff. I have three Shadow Seers, all level 2, one with the Mask of Secrets. I have two units of Skyreaver Jet Bikes, both with Zephyr Blades, and Haywire Cannons. I have a Void Weaver with Prismatic Cannon, three Death Jesters, and a Solitaire.
Alright, so there it is, 1500 points of Harlequins. And here is my 1500 points of Astra Militarum, led by my not Colonel Ironhand Straken. This is the old Vestroian Colonel, but he's also more machine than man, so I basically just use him as Straken. His command squad also has a banner, a medic, a voxcaster, and a meltagun in it. Then for my other HQs, I have an engine seer and a plain Jane commissar with a power sword. I have two veteran squads in chimeras, both of which have heavy stubbers. Then they also, I think, have extra armor and or relic plating. I can't remember exactly what I gave them. But my veteran squads have carapace armor, so the extra carapace is the Forge World veteran upgrades, basically with the cool rebreathers and stuff. Laz cans, plasma guns, no other upgrades on the guys. I have a single Hellhound with a Dozer Blade. I have a Tempestus Scion, actually Kazurkin, let's call them what they're actually supposed to be, which is Kazurkin. I've got a Flamer, a Meltagun, and a Vet with a Power Sword, and a Plasma Pistol in it. And I have two Armored Sentinels with Laz Cannons. I have a pair of Lehman Russes with Laz Cannons and Heavy Bolter Sponsons. And I gave them Relic Plating as well. So there it is, 1500 points of Astra Militarum. The Spoils of War is the Maelstrom Mission we're playing. There will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 objectives on the table, and it's a standard 12-inch deployment. It goes with 3 tactical objectives per turn, but any tactical objectives that are numeric taken holds become available to both players. So if we draw tactical objectives that are, for instance, control objective 1, control objective 5, whatever, we put them in the middle over here, and both of us can do them because we can steal them from each other. Slay the Warlord, Linebreaker, and I think First Blood are also on the table, and we'll be playing, I think, a random game like the 5 turns plus a roll. So here it is, our setup. We're going to roll right now for deployment. See who's deploying and picking sides. 3.
And 6.
So you can choose sides.
Yeah, I'll choose this side.
All right, let's get deployed. We got a Lehman Russ with an engine seer. We've got a Chimera with a Laz Cannon Sentinel in behind. We have my Hellhound, my command squad cowering behind the shrine, calling an air support, which will hopefully get here by turn 5. And we got other Chimera with Laserman and another Lehman Russ over here. Across from us, we have the Void Spinner.
Void Reaper, sorry, that's right.
Two jet bikes. We have the first, second, and third unit of identical guard or Harlequins. This one's got the Warlord in it, though, and the dude with the minus 2 leadership relic. And then the other unit of jet bikes is behind this building here. So I can attempt to seize. Otherwise, you choose who's going first. Or no, you go first. That's right.
Yeah, I'll go.
You're gonna go first. Okay. So it's gonna be me seizing on a 6. 6. Oh, that's not even the right dice. That might have been a 6, just the wrong kind. And no, it's a 1. That's exactly correct. We're on his tactical objectives now. It's sort of his turn. We are not playing ITC rules this time, which means he will be drawing and I will be drawing at the start of our own turns and scoring at the end of our own turns. He's got Domination, Supremacy, and Kingslay.
Oh, if you're measuring, that's why it works.
That's right. So running on up. Now, everything in his army basically ignores terrain. Just flies through it. Except the jet bikes.
Skip it.
Because
skip it,
drunk jet bikes may fly into walls and die. The last time I played against Harlequins, that was how most of the jet bikes died.
Was I'm trying to try to avoid that.
There's the Warlord squad moved up. Then we got the last squad all moved.
Some of these stupid things.
Okay. And they're going to fly in their fly machines.
Yeah. Let's see how far away it'd be to shoot your stupid.
And up they go. Trying to get some shots on the Hellhounds. Other jet bikes coming through the building. Jester, or sorry, not Jester, Jester Solitaire. He just goes 12. Just goes 12, because he's a solitaire. Warp charges, we got two. Plus one, two, three.
Plus six.
Four? Yeah, it's five, six, or two each. That's right.
Tiers on this unit here. Need one success, and I got two.
Okay, I'm not going to bother trying to get rid of it.
Squad, one success.
I have three dice left. To get rid of it, three dice left. Yeah, I'll burn one dice, just try.
Nope. Same thing, Veil of Tears. Nope.
Nope, doesn't go around.
Plus.
Five.
I'm okay with that.
Third boosting over the objective. Well, with the Warlord, they're going six this turn. They are. Seven AP2 Lance from the Prismatic Cannon going.
Does it hit on a three plus? It sure does. So it will glance on a five. That's a hit.
Potato. And
no. Nothing. That's where that dice comes in handy. But that's going to go off four.
Yeah. Okay, second one hits me.
So Haywire, two is a glance.
We've got Phantasmas-y. No.
I got Supremacy. Okay. So I control at least twice as many as you and at least two.
All right, three, which will be worth
one.
One. So it's just worth one, so we just put the card in the pile. Objectives, Secure Objective 2, Psychological Warfare, and Ascendancy. Objective 2 is up for grabs, and we can both score that one, which means he's probably going to get it because it's right over here. And then Psychological Warfare and Ascendancy, man. It's moving up here to grab this objective because it's 3 inches tall on the turret, and that's a 3-inch objective. Dangerous Train Test. Mr. Tanky Tank here is going to move six up like so. Oops, to here. Climb the walls as they do. They're going to go five. So it's two up and then three in, which we'll put them right here.
Pretty good.
Fast Tank, he's going to not move up yet. Yeah, he's going to move up slightly. He's going to move up four. He's going to move up to here. Actually, I'm going to move this guy another 6 inches, I've decided. Like so. Movement in the movement phase. So let's start shooting some guns. And just get themselves on the objective. They go three. So secure objective number one. With him, he's just not going to quite go all the way six, just to three. So he can offset grab this from the salt. Sentinel, it's going to shoot into this guy.
Cool. I'm going to use my Mirage Launcher. So get 4 plus the model save.
Sounds good. So hang on, four. Gonna miss. He's gonna put his template over on dice. Goes backwards, nothing. So it's gonna land right there. He's opting to use his Mirage Launcher. He's now down to two of the house limit of duos. So we're on twos. One wound, one whatever save, 4+.
4+.
Good. Misses. And then heavy wound. Nice. If we could kill something. So there's four hits. This'll do it. This is how it gets done. Threes, one wound.
All right, 4+.
Nope. Let's see if we can see this squad over here with the Hellhound. And that's going to be 14 inch all the way back to the two characters. So they'll have to make some look answers.
As long as these guys die first.
Oh, okay, cool. Well, it's strength 6, AP good. So let's see what happens. 5 2s, all wound.
Okie doke. So I'm going to start on these three guys here.
That's right.
Rerolling once. So they'll one, all two, take three. It on these two front guys.
They're still closest. I'm playing the wrong game right now.
There's two guys there in the front.
I'll start be on fours. I don't know why I keep rolling this artillery dice.
One hits.
One hits, and then two's to wound. And I keep rolling the artillery dice. One wound.
On the front guy, he takes it too.
Okay. You can actually see him through the door. This Chimera is going to start lighting up this. The veterans inside, manning the las guns, hitting on threes against this troop. And then wounding on fours, I cannot believe the last guns are doing as well. Ha! Oh. Screw you, Lehman Russ, 5 wounds. 5+ invulnerable.
Alright, I'll throw the front 3 guys and I'll attempt to do some lookouts there.
Sure, sounds good.
Alright, so it's 2 passed so far, so okay. 2 guys die. And I'll do one more on him and then I'll have to go on the character.
Yep, sounds good.
He rerolls ones, nope. Still dead. And I'll do a save on him.
Okay.
He has 2 wounds and he's okay.
Spazer. Is going to fire on fours, and then wound on twos, strength 6, nope, and then heavy B, and then wound on twos, two saves, but these don't cause instant death.
Alright, I'll start with one of my true master.
Sounds good.
5 up, He's good. And on a troop master, 5 up. No, he takes a wound.
And then the heavy stubber on 4s. And then on 3s now. And he's going to make some lookouncers, I assume.
Oh, yeah.
3 lookouncers.
3 lookouncers, 2 plus. They all go up.
So into regular schmoes. On 5s.
5 up.
So 2 more. Right, let's do a last cannon shot into these bikes back here. Hit. Doesn't hit. He's going to fire. He's going to place his ordnance template right here. We are going to roll to scout. I go backwards many inches and 5. Destroy this building.
Bam!
Remember that I'm actually snap firing when I fire ordnance, because, you know, I kind of play this game. 6s. 1. We got 2s. 5 plus.
On this guy, I think it's closest.
Sure.
These two middle guys. Hey, he's okay.
And last cannon.
And they pass with a...
At the end of the turn, objective secure is going to get me this objective. I have this one and this one over here, and that's going to score me D3 objective points, or victory points. 2! So drawing some new tactical objectives, we drew take and hold 6.
Objective 6, yep. Yep,
and that was it. We didn't discard anything. So, movement phase.
Time to get Kingslayer.
Oh, he's going to go for it. Going to go fight not Straken. Steph's just leading the squad. Going to go grab objective.
And these guys are going to move forward.
And hopefully when this is dead, grab objective.
That is the plan. Hopefully not get shot to death. Seems like a thing you would do. And yeah, these guys will go around here.
Leading the squad, so he can go and try and murder someone with a gun.
And these guys will move forward.
It's cool the way that you can have these little like objective holders pop off your squads. And go and like just kind of secure things. Tiger and Yellow Tiger, they could do things. Or Blue Lion and Yellow Lion. Anyone who gets that reference is old. Squad going into the building, secure 5.
There's not many guys left in the squad.
I did make some of them full of bullets. You're walking away as well. And then the bikes.
How far do I gotta be to shoot you? Around here. Is this gonna be a good spot to be? Death just
charge. 3. And you've got tears, goes up with 1. I'll burn a dice, try and kill it. And I don't.
3 dice. Got it with 1.
Give me 6. I do! It's gone!
Ooh,
brutal. 1 dice left.
And on these guys here. They got it with 1.
6! What'd I roll? I rolled a 6!
Ah! Cannon into the side of this Chimera. Right.
Armor 10 on the side.
So BS5, hitting on 2s.
Yeah.
Strength 6. So that's...
4s, 1 pen. AP dash.
And that is 3, so shaken.
Can't shoot.
Yeah, just death gesture shooting it as well.
Yep, sounds good.
Your armor 12 on the front, right?
Yeah, 2s.
So 2s to hit. And 6 is to glance. Nothing. Bikes are shooting into the Chimera as well.
Okay.
Haywire cannons. So the first shot is going to go off.
It'll still hit me.
Yep.
It's going 2 inches.
And the second shot is a hit.
Yeah, so 2 pluses, and it's gone.
2 haywires. 2 glances.
Recoveries from this wall. It's over 25%, but doesn't matter. It's still wrecked. And for the Commissar, they're fine. You didn't even have to execute anybody.
Shoot next. So these two suits are going to be firing into this Chimera.
Okay.
So the Death Jester is going to shoot first.
Sounds good.
So he has his Stricken Cannon. 3 shots, hitting on 2s and glancing on 6s. So hitting on 2s. And 6s.
No. Hands, I'll put the thing over top. So my minus 4 scatter.
Hits.
Next one.
Hits. Excellent.
All right, so 2 on 2s.
So 2 haywires, that's a pen and a glance.
Uh-oh, so 2 hull points, and the pen
is... And the pen is immobilized.
Oh, 1 hull point left and immobilized.
Shoot into the sentinel.
Alright, sounds good, right here.
Yep, so what's your armor value?
11, because I'm armored.
Great, so my shuriken cannon will shoot first, hitting on 3s.
Yeah.
1 hit, and I think 5's glance, doesn't matter. And I'll fire my focused prism cannon, so 3 is to hit. Strength 7, 4 is to glance. And it's a pen.
See what happens.
And that's caught. AP 2.
So 6, so immobilized.
Immobilized. I'm going to run. 4 inches, I'll keep that.
And then charge. Yeah, 2 inches.
I'll reroll that with fleet. Nope.
Worse.
Even worse.
Just move the back out of the front. That's the easiest way to do it. Hey,
great. These folks are also going to run. 3. Yeah, I'll keep that. They will go over here.
Comes the building. They're done. So who's charging?
The bikes are going to charge the unit.
Are they? Well, that's going to keep me from snap firing something good. So I guess I'll snap fire them. Laser cannon. No. Plasma gun. No. And then many las guns. Here. There's 2 on 5s. Nope. And then the pistol from the Commissar hits not at all.
Well, how far?
They're going eight. And I waste my Snapfire.
Six.
And I get no Snapfire because he declared a smart charge with some bikes.
And these guys charging the Hellhounds.
What's that?
Seven.
More bananas in the tailpipe. Making them just
run in, and then these guys.
To see how far away they are from stuff. They're about
seven.
Eight.
Yeah,
seven.
Eight.
These guys with four. They're also going to charge the Hellhound too.
So needing, not that. Same thing. It was 7-8.
Yeah, not enough.
Solitaire, I'm going to do my stand shoots. So I got Meltagun. Get him. Nope. I got, looks like 1, 2, 3, 4 Laz pistols / Laz guns. So 2 Laz gun, 2 Laz gun, and then Laz pistol. And then shotguns. They're all the same, basically, from the not striking over here. Sixes. No. Oh, wait, one. Fours? I won't.
Okay.
Three. Roll two. Ah, he rolls at ones, that's right. Roll a two!
Oh, yeah.
Hey, look, you rolled anything.
Ten.
That's enough. That's enough anything. All right, and I have to issue a challenge. Piling three, so you get two more guys, it looks like, and then some rocks.
Yeah.
And the punching begins.
Kisses that are just strength six.
Hitting on threes.
Okay.
And then
wounding on fours.
Four is a glance, that's two pens. It's AP2.
Yay!
So that's immobilized and immobilized.
Boom! Yeah, no, so it's just immobilized. The last one.
So then he gets five Harlequin caress attacks.
Woo!
So when he sixes to hit, auto glance.
Why did they get one each? Wouldn't they get like three each?
It's only one of their attacks is a kiss.
Oh, right, okay. Wow. Got it.
Yeah. So this guy sixes glance. That's one glance.
Dad.
You my pilot.
You sure do.
So initiative seven first.
Yeah, pretty sure you're gonna get to pilot however you want.
And my troop master will challenge you.
Yeah, except with the commissar.
See you on threes.
Weapon skill four, yep.
Weapon skill seven, I think.
Seven? And wounding on...
No, weapon skill six.
Okay.
So that's three hits.
Yep.
Strike four on the charge. Please? So wounding you on threes. So that's one AP three wound.
So dead.
Okay. And initiative 7 as well, my Shadow Zero will ledge you with his Mistave.
Sounds good.
So hitting on 3s and Fleshbane. Well, that's one caught die and one hit, so I reroll the caught, so that's 2 hits.
And 2's wound.
2's to wound.
And then my Veterans with Carapace Armor get 4 plus saves against this.
Whew.
Which I crank both of.
Sweet.
Initiative 1,000 million, everybody else piles in. The caresses are the ones which the hits of 6 become AP2. Threes.
So that's one AP2 wound.
Yep.
And everything else hits except for that one miss.
Is that auto wound too?
Auto wound.
Got it, okay. And then these ones went on threes?
Fours.
Fours.
Because, no, threes, yeah.
Yeah, first charge.
First charge. So that's
five regular saves and one guy dead. 5-4 plus saves. Come on! Three dead. You. And then randos, whoop, kisses.
So these guys, one of their attacks is a kiss attack. The other attacks are all normal basic
just
attacks.
Just normie attacks, yep.
So I'll do the normal attacks first and the
weapon
kiss attack.
Weapon skill 1,000 million.
Weapon skill 5, initiative 6.
Threes.
So threes to hit. Not too bad. And fours to wound.
Just kill them all so I can shoot you.
One, two, three. Three saves.
Three saves, okay. And then the kisses.
Yeah. So hitting on threes.
Moving on threes.
Two, strike six.
Two, strike six, okay.
Or seven on the charge.
AP?
AP two.
Okay, so one more dead. And then I got three saves. Two more dead. So the U and a plasma gun. Piling now. Whoop. Get him, Sarge. Sarge with Laz gun, best Sarge ever. 3, 4, 5, 6 attacks. Wound. There's two hits. Seven. Leadership Snake Eyes. No.
Oh, so close.
Chase me plus I can't even get away. Four to. You get
seven,
nine, I get seven. Yeah, no. 2 inches?
Two. Not enough to get the objective.
This is a challenge because I have to with my not striking over here. You are initiative 10, weapon skill 9, so you get to go first with 1,000 million attacks.
Cool. So we have 6 attacks base plus 1 for charging.
Okay.
And 1 for weapons, but one of the attacks is a kiss of death attack.
Sweet.
So these ones are Harlequin's Caress, so any 6 is to hit, auto wounded AP2.
Awesome.
So that's 2 automatic AP2 wounds.
Okay, so 2 for Factor Field saves.
And then wounding on 3, sorry. So 3 armor saves,
okay.
And 2 of honorable saves so far, and the Kiss of Death. Hitting on 3s, nope. So that's 2 of honorable saves.
2 invulnerables and 3 regulars. So I have 3 plus regular armor, because I'm mostly machine. Take 1 wound. And then the 2 refractor field saves on 5s. I make one, so I take another one.
All right, so I get to hit you back with him then. And that means I'm throwing a grand total of 4 attacks in Mexico's Calvin. I'm strength 6 with smash, so you just get your whatever save you would get normally anyway. Weapon skill 5 though, so I do hit you on 4s, because you're on weapon skill 10. And then I wound you on 2, strength 6, but you are Eternal Warrior, so I can't give you. And roll 2!
No,
these guys will get to fight you too. They are all veterans, which means they have las guns and Mexico's Calvin.
Vets. Yeah, they've all got las guns. They come with them. They hit on 5s though, because we're almost going 9. But I still hit you 5 times apparently.
Yes, yes, go down, the men.
Best bodyguard.
4s, 2 wounds, roll 2 2s, double 2s.
1 2.
Uh oh, it takes a wound. So it's.
Down to 2.
2 to 1.
So nobody runs.
Score, you're going to discard domination because it's hard to get every single objective.
Just come in.
Some. Deep strike!
Paratroops.
Yeah, the show.
Say, who dares wins. So we're going to try and drop right here.
Troops.
They go sideways 11. Drew Kingslayer, so I get D3 victory points for killing the enemies of Warlord
movement. This guy's gonna move up 6. Like so. Is he?
No, he's not gonna
jump out the top hatch here. Me and KG jumping at the side hatch.
This fella is going to move. He's gonna go 6. Oh, no, he's gonna go 6 this way.
Charge me, charge me.
I'm gonna charge you so much as I'm going to run away from you while shooting. Slash towards
up slightly.
Whoop. Like so.
Your dangerous train. Oh, emo
guns o'clock. We're gonna rapid fire into these guys. Is going to be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 times 3, 4, 5, 6. Yeah, that's right, because everybody else got special weapons. No, you should have a las gun. You're from there. I could actually have 2 las guns in the squad though, because it's a veteran squad. Sorry, 2 plasma guns. So that's gonna be 7, 14 rapid fires.
3s, because they went to shoot camp. And these all go away.
Reroll that, even though it hits, just because it was cocked. Yep, and then forced wound. Let's make some dead space clowns. That's going to be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 space clown saves on 5 boss.
All right, I'm going to start on this guy in the front there. He
dead.
Rolls once.
Still dead.
Ooh.
This is where we get funky. This is one of those armies where you just keep rolling individual saves.
Right, I'm going to roll on my warlord. He gets to have a 3 plus invulnerable save because he ran.
That's right.
So 3 plus.
Takes a wound.
Oof. All right, do I keep on going?
You do. You have to.
Look out, sir, or...
I think you have to when you start rolling wounds, yeah. Look out, sir.
No, I'm going to keep going on him.
Okay.
I'm going to risk it. He rerolls once.
Dead. Dead. Next one.
I'll do this guy here.
Yep, 5s. Good.
And on him again. He's good.
6.
You think with a 3 plus reroll.
It was cocked, so I'll do it again. Nope. And then 2 from the plasma guns on 3s. I don't know why I rolled that artillery dice. 2 hits. We're going to 2s. 2 saves. Invulnerable. 5 plus.
Grab the front.
Dead.
And the Shadow Seer.
Dead. Can make a look at it, sir. Now down to 1 do-over. Passes. So let's get
correct. Didn't realize it was plasma.
Last cannon from this Sentinel. Into him. Misses.
From here into this squad.
Walter. It's going to hit once. Went on 2s. Dozen wounds. Why did I roll 4 dice? I don't even know. But I'm glad nothing happened. And then my multi-laser on 4s. Doesn't do anything. And the Heavy Stubber on 4s. Does 2. And then wounds on 3s. Always the Heavy Stubber getting worked on. 1 wound. Front guy.
Got yep. Front.
He's
he dies.
He's going to go into this sawer dude.
The rest that immobilizes itself
is going to put a big blast right on his head. Yep. 24. All kinds of. So let's see if I hit him. It's going to go sideways 1 inch. That will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. On the 2s. 7. I got sirs. Well, I guess you start making wounds. So start with this guy. That's the troop master right there.
Who's troop master?
Him? Okay. 5s?
Nope. He's dead.
Troop master?
Yeah, okay, so we'll do 4 lookups to get on the troop members.
Okay.
So it's going to be 1 on the troop master.
Okay.
5 up.
And he's dead.
And then 3 on the troop members. 2 of them are dead.
And there's 2 left.
Shadow suit?
Yep. Fail them both.
He's going to take both of them. He takes reroll once. He dies.
Last cannon in the squad. Misses. Snap firing 2 sets of heavy bolters. 1 hits and 2s to wound. 1 wound. 1 regular save. 5 plus.
No.
These fellas are going to shoot your jet bikes. So he does get a save. The flamethrower is going to hit him as well. So the flamer, do the ancillary hit on a 3. Wounds him. So a save for this guy.
Oh, he's, it's part of the same unit. Oh, it's different squads.
Did he join the squad?
He did.
He did? Okay, that's fine then. So, yeah.
That's one wound. Three so wounds. Far.
Two more rolls on fours. Just one wound. So, his save. Unless he wants to look it out.
You look out, sir.
Does.
He goes onto a bike. And the bike takes
shot away. From the Sarge, which misses and overheats and kills me. No, it doesn't. Melt again shot. We'll do that last. Actually, we'll do everybody else, which is seven more guys with hell guns. Because they're stormtroopers. Ones and twos go away.
It's pretty good.
Reroll that because it was kind of not flat. And then fives. That will be uno, dos, tres, cuatros. You want to do some lookouts?
Yeah, for sure. So three lookouts, sir, so far. So two on the death jester.
Uh-oh.
He's okay.
What?
And then one force. Save all on the bikes. He rerolls ones.
Okay.
He's okay.
Okay.
And there's one wound left, right?
The melt again? No, that was it.
There was how many? Three or four?
Oh, it's four. That's right. Yeah,
so one more. I'll do the death jester.
Okay.
That's it caught. He rerolls ones. And he takes a wound.
Hits. Wounds.
Yeah, I'm going to look out through this.
That makes sense.
He does.
Passing.
On to the bikes.
Four plus.
Yep.
Gonna put a template right on his head. Goes 1 inch back, still hits everybody.
Yeah.
And sorry, actually 2 inches back, but I think it still hits everybody. And then we've got the wounding rolls on threes.
Two.
Two, sorry. So two. Two lookouts. Nice. When we look out, so
no, this on the bikes. Guys.
Four plus.
We're vulnerable. We're rolling ones.
Uh-oh.
So one bike.
Yeah.
Okay.
You take a whole wound off if you want. Maybe the closest guy, but I don't think you can. I guess it would matter.
Yeah, guy
it would,
has to
it
take
would
it.
Matter. Yeah, you're right. No, you're right. So, snap firing last gun, or last cannon. Hits, twos. Another propulsive vulnerable. Do it.
Yeah.
Good. And then heavy bees, times zero on sixes. Two more on threes. Two more saves, four plus. That's how you do it.
One on each, they're both dead.
Yeah. Leadership 10.
Leadership 9.
9. Uh-oh, he's gone.
And he's running four inches. Come on, little guy.
Please.
Run away.
He's fearless. These guys.
Leadership 10.
Oh, fails. My God. Okay. And go 11 inches. Pace, we're out.
Oof.
Matt, your initiative 1,000 million.
Freeze. All right, so these.
Still a challenge, yeah.
Sixes, so that's three automatic AP2 moves.
Okay. Come on, Vaxerfield.
And then wounding on fours. So one armor save.
Okay, so one, three
and
plus.
Kiss of death.
A kiss of death, yeah.
Hitting on threes.
Hits.
Wounding on twos. So that's instant death, AP 2.
Okay. I'm pretty sure I'm not alive. All right, my if I fail any of these, I die. Refractorfield saves, all five plus. Oh, almost. He's dead.
Squad.
Switch, someone will just die, and then an armor save. The armor save. I did get feel no pain against the AP2, though.
It's
I got feel no pain. Oh, that, I would have gotten feel no pain against this, though, because I have a
you
medic.
Would have, yeah.
Actually, I would have gotten feel no pain against all those wounds. I made none. He's going to just die from this in death attack. We're going to take Johnny Voxlink over here. And then the regular armor save on a 4+. Sorry, 5+, rather. He's going to fight. That's 6 attacks. Oh, Straken. On fours. Fives, rather, sorry. Two. And on fours. Control 2/2s right now. Go down. Nice. Of 8. Lose by 2. Down to 6.
And you're minus 2 because of him as well.
Okay. Well,
I roll. Doesn't matter.
Down. No, it does matter. Rerolling for my banner. I run. I get. Go. Yeah, I can't even win.
Do you beat 10?
No.
Woo.
Go six.
6 inches. Terrifying. Down there somewhere.
Okay. Running over here.
Yeah.
I got Kingslayer for D3 because it killed your Warlord. So I get. Oh, it was a 3 for a second. I got 2. And I also got Psychological Warfare because I made something run away. You fail 3 or did you fail 2?
I failed 2.
So you only get 1 for that. 3, drawing some objectives.
Objective 6 and objective 2.
So now you're dumping Kingslayer?
Oh, no, because I drew.
You would achieve Kingslayer during my turn? No, you scored during your turn.
My turn. But I need 3, right?
And you've got 6 still.
Oh, sorry.
That's right.
Put one back.
Yeah, that's great. It's weird because we have these shared ones. We feel like you don't have. Do it!
Oh!
It was half of it.
And this guy here.
And 6 as well, yeah.
Nope. No.
It's okay. Death Jesters will save the day. Those guys.
These guys.
9.
One more turn to try to
rally. Blitz, try and get some work done.
So he will go 5, 6 inches.
Oh, man. Hilariously, exactly his normal movement.
Half of it.
He's got. Oh, that's right. He goes slower than normal. I was detectives because he's behind now. He's gonna go bike town. to try and get way over to this one because it's on the table, and then Death Jester's can probably get the other one.
So Death Jester's gonna go run over that way.
Easy move as well.
You only have one hull point left.
What's your side armor value?
11? No, 10 because it's Russ. No, 12. It doesn't even matter.
And these guys.
Oh, these guys.
These guys.
This already moved.
This guy.
This guy. Don't you worry about this little guy.
He has to try not to die. Okay. He's going to go over here.
Disregard that, Robin. Siker.
Yeah,
three. You get so five.
So he's going to cast Veil of Tears on himself.
Makes sense.
He gets it with three.
Yeah, I'm not going to try to stop phase. He doesn't have really anything else worth doing. Sir, or sorry, the Solitaire. Six. So now he gets his normal movement. And ends an inch away from
go Eldar banana crazy flat out to turbo boost over here.
Shoot into these guys.
Of course.
So shuriken cannon hitting on twos. So that's a precision strike. Okay. So I'll do it on your sergeant.
Sounds good.
So against the sergeant, wounding on twos. And against the squad, wounding Shmo. On twos.
Okay, so the sergeant on a four. He dies, and the squad guy dies too.
Here, shooting into the sentinel.
Okay, one whole point left.
All right. I'll hit. Hits,
and then you need fives.
One pen. So I'm going to start off with the shuriken cannon. So three shots, hitting on threes.
Okay.
And armor 12, so sixes glance.
Nope.
And the prism cannon, hitting on threes.
Whoa, launcher. So we shoot some illusions. So they're illusions, Michael.
So it's a strength one blast. If it hits, you take a pity test.
Okay.
There's a scatter die right here.
That's what we use for blasts. Or his head.
Hey, it misses.
No, it doesn't. Oh, minus two. Five?
Minus four.
Okay. Yeah, no,
you still hit.
Heavy still. So strength one, you said? So yep. Sixes? Two guys?
Hey, one.
Four blasts? No, pin test. It's going to kill Shmo. And then I make a pin test on leadership eight. Because we are stormtroopers, we're fine. We do not care about your sparkly Eldar space dress. Special scary rule. Morale test at minus two, so on a six. I'm fine.
I think.
Can you go for it? On an eight.
Either that, you were up and charge me, so I might as well charge you. Oh, he's catching the objective. No, he's not going to charge.
Just keep his eyes on the ball. Charge. All right, I will snap fire. So, last cannon, six. Nope. Plasma gun, sixes. Nope. And now 1,000,000,000 guns. This is what we'll do it. This is how solitaires die. Yes, yes, we have enough. Force to wound. One. Roll me a two. Roll me a two. Oh, he's good.
Plasma guns?
I did my plasma guns already. Oh. Challenge him a sergeant. He's not very good at fighting. He mostly shoots a rifle.
Great. I have 10 attacks
this turn. 10 base, extra up and charged, hitting on threes.
So these are the caress.
Whoa.
So that is four automatic AP2 wounds.
Yay. That's five, actually.
Oh, five there. Automatic AP2 wounds.
So five, half the squad's dead.
And two hits otherwise.
Hooray.
Hey, it's one more save.
One more save.
And then the kiss of death. So hitting on threes, wounding on twos. That's instant death AP2.
Okay. Armor save. Nope. So seven guys are dead. You three guardsmen. I'm going to have you kill him right now. I want you to do this. Do this for the Emperor. Do you love the Emperor? Because now you're going to kill this guy. Hit him on fives. He's weapon skill bajillion. It didn't even add up to five.
What happened to you right now?
Can't even roll high.
There's, no, leadership first.
Oh, that's right. Yeah, leadership bad. So leadership
you snake guys. Yet?
Yeah, I did. And I can't win the initiative roll, so just make it consolidate.
One.
1 inch.
Just stay where I am.
D3. Okay. Give you one.
Twice. One.
And objective two.
Unobjective two, so we got five.
So three total. For five total.
Yeah.
Because you get my objective too. More objectives. We have secure three, secure four, and harness the warp. If I successfully manifest psychic power, well, that's not going to happen. But luckily you can't do that one. I have a play here. It's not a good play, but it is a play. So we're going to go 6 inches over here. He's just going to stay right here. The scions, which I call stormtroopers, because that's what they should be called. When I was a lad, these guys were called stormtroopers, and they stormed all the troops. Start first, we're going to laser cannon you on a four. Nope, I've yet to hit with laser. All of the explodey death guns from this thing into this troop over here. Pits.
I think you hit.
So twos. One, jinking save.
Four up cover. Yeah!
Last cannon. Dozen hits. And then one hit on a three. Potato. Let's do it again. One wound. Four plus. Ooh.
So one guy is dead.
So you multi-laser slash heavy bolter into them. One hit on two. Check six. Wounds.
4 plus chink.
4 plus.
Good. Heavy B. 2 hits. Winning on 3s. Roll it again because it's cocked. Nope. It's a 1.
4 plus.
Nope. Is going to take some shots into him. So let's do... I'm not going to bother with the battle cannon. I'm just going to start cranking with everything else because I think it's a better play.
Yeah.
So last cannon on a 4. Misses. Heavy B's on a 4. Yeah, this is the better play. Twos. Twos. There's, roll it again. 4 wounds.
You only have to pass 3 of these.
Okay. You'll be fine. 5s.
Nope. Ah, so
blame
close.
Blame him. So it's just an auto hit. 3s. And wounds. 5 plus.
5 plus.
Nope. Negative hits. Wounds. 5 plus.
No.
7. Bam! Wounds. Roll 2.
No, nope. You like just first. Kay. Like glance on 6s if I hit. So hitting on 3s.
Okay.
Glancing on 6s. I do.
Oh. So 1 whole point.
And then the caress. 6s will auto glance.
This may have been a
6s. Ill-advised. None.
Nothing. Yay. Fear to hit. Why do I keep rolling this dice? 5s to hit. Oh.
Hey, you got
one. 2s. Roll a 2. Oh, it was almost a 2.
I do.
Yay. You have to pick a direction before you roll.
Yep. Stupid tanks. I'm going to roll towards the Leave It Rust.
Okay.
So I'll go 10.
So you have to stay an inch away from the Chimera when he does it, because if you ignore him, he can't ignore the rest of them when he moves over. It's in the bike. We'll make it right now.
9? He fails?
He fails. 10? So he's going to go...
off the table.
13 off the table. 3. And we go to turn 4. You ejected 5 and kill things in the assault phase, which sounds like a good thing for you. Consolidate this dude, and he's going to go 5. And consolidate away from the murder thing. Surprisingly. Mr. Group them? No, it was a double, just not the right one.
And these, this guy here? Does he regroup?
No.
Not even close.
So running for him, he's gonna go...
6?
6, not too bad.
Or 6, they're gone.
One last chance! Base plane. Gonna move. Moving him. Towards 5. Tank. Death Tester's not gonna bother trying to go for the tank, he's gonna try to get the objective instead.
Yeah, 2 dice.
And you get... 4,
please, please, sorry, please.
Veil. So 2. Both go off. You can have it. One, right?
Yeah. So 2 successes. Oh,
boxcars!
6 strength, 3 shots.
Oh! Something?
So it hits. 8.
3, just go 4. That's not great. And then forced wound.
2.
2, 2 4 plus armor saves. Pass 1. Fail 1, and it's a blind test.
Mm-hmm. So it's an initiative test.
Initiative, so if I roll less than a 3. I was going to take a pistol shot into my stormtroopers.
So shuriken pistol.
Hits.
And wounds on 3s.
Wounds, 4 plus. Nope, it was a guy.
Hmm.
Going to go 3, probably not quite make it to the objective.
So I think I'm going to re-roll with fleet.
Okay. Needs a 5, 6 probably. 4. It's not going to make it. Zapping over the objective with the flyer. Or the skimmer, rather. Sure. Try and get over here. 6. He's got it. Not quite enough, but it's his for sure next turn. Yeah, stormtroopers on 8. They're fine. So that's one more for you.
And that's it.
All right. Because I don't have a psych. 3. We got no prisoners. Objective 2, objective 5. We're going to go sentinel over here. 6. He's going to go 12. So that's 8 to there. And he's going to go 4. To here. Oops. Just walk right up to the door over here. Whoop. Like so. And not shoot this turn because I'm going to have to run, but such is life. Let's shoot some guns. We're going to start with him. Mm-hmm. He's going to not fire his bottle cannon. He's going to just start firing like crazy into that guy because I think it's the better play. So,
oh, no.
Last cannon. I don't know why I'm rolling that dice because I picked it up. Hits. 2 plus. 5 plus invulnerable.
Yep. Nope.
He's nope, dead. And I'll score that objective. He's going to try and see him, which he does, which is 16. Laz cannon to him. Hits.
Now
2 plus.
Hit.
Wounds. 5 plus. Make it! Dead.
Reroll.
Dead.
Ah.
Dead. All guns. Snap firing. So snap firing everything into the murder man. So heavy B, 6s. 1 hit. 2s. Nope. And then multi-laser 6s. 1 hit. 2s.
Nope. And then heavy stubber. That boy with the battle cannon. So we're gonna go last cannon. Misses. And six heavy bees. This is what's gonna do it. Get them. Fours. This is what I need here. Just need two twos. Twos. Three twos. Roll three twos.
Zzz. So we roll
three
the ones.
On the ones. Yeah, I take some wounds. Up right now, because I could potentially get D3, or I can get two for sure if I just run. I'm going to go for the for sure two and run. So I'm going to run over here and hang out in this building. So end of round, I will score objective five twice. I'll score one for no prisoners because I couldn't kill a third guy. Ascendancy, so D3, if he scores three objective markers at the end of the turn. He's only got two units left, but you got a rally potentially. Hey, rally.
They not even close.
They're a line breaker. Because he was like an inch and a half short from scoring that with him. And then he's going to go score two. Because the play was, if he was in range, he could zip over here, flat out, and grab this for 2 points, and then blood and guts me. But he didn't have the range. Turbo boost over to my deployment zone. Because why not?
I'm going to go up behind the wall so you can't see me.
Sure, over here.
Boop, boop, or yeah, there. It's right there.
So he just camps the objective for two, because he's going to grab both these objective twos. More. Hey, it's secure objective two again. You're welcome. For free, basically. And then one and scour the skies, which doesn't mean anything. We're going to go 12 with him, so eight. Whoop. And then four. And try not to immobilize ourselves, I guess. Get them, because they're in a building. It's going to be four. They just need to get line of sight on Johnny Murder Pants over there.
Don't worry.
Actually, you know what? No. They're going to go get into this thing. He's gonna move. He's gonna go two and then four. Over like, yeah. He's gonna run. He just needs to run one to get next to the objective. He does. Whoop, he runs two. I'm actually just gonna snap fire. Or not move over here rather than snap fire, just making sure I'm on top. Hits. Twos. Roll a two.
Good.
Good. And then six heavy bees. Fours. Just need one here. Twos. Two saves. Roll a two. All
right. Please don't
roll fail. Roll two. Oh. Yeah. That. There's no one to fire through the wall. So that's that. So ending turn five. I've secured one. I've secured two for two more. Skies I can't do. I'll see if the game ends. All right, so there we have it. Counting at the end, 13 for me. I scored 11 tactical objectives, plus I managed to get, at the end of the game, Linebreaker and Slay the Warlord. You got 9 tactical objectives, plus you got Linebreaker and Slay the Warlord as well, and First Blood.
And First Blood.
That's right, so you get to 12? No, you get 8 and plus 3 yeah. To 11. So 13-11, super close game, very bloody, Harlequins versus Astra Militarum. Hope you guys enjoyed it. Jared, thanks for coming down for some 40K, man.
Hey, no worries, thanks a lot.
Yeah, hopefully you'll come back and we'll get to do some more gaming. I haven't played you in a while. We'll see you for more Dark Millennium in the future. Until then, guys, thanks for watching. Happy Wargaming.